Surprise, motherfucker.
What's up, guys? It's Attack of the Games here, and I don't know about you, but I'm feeling pretty good about that little server thing that I just did there. It's my first time doing it, and if you guys enjoyed that, please hit a like button. Now, for today's video, we're going to be talking about Battlefield 1. I'm going to be leaving a gameplay impression, you know, things that I thought were really good, things that I really hoped they would keep in the full game, and obviously things that went bad. Now, before we get off again, I'd like to say to the people that are watching right now, thank you. You guys are helping me grow. We all have to start somewhere, so I scratch your back, you scratch mine, etc., etc. Like the video, comment what I did wrong so I can get better, and subscribe. And yeah, now we're into it. Battlefield 1 is easily 2016's most anticipated game. And, you know, they gave us an open beta so we can try out new things like they do every single year. Because Battlefield is a very wide-known series, and it does have its setbacks like Battlefield 3's launch date, Battlefield 4's, and Hardline. Now, I'm really hoping that this doesn't happen to Battlefield 1, because this is a really good game, but it does have some of its negatives. Now, let's get into the pros. Starting off, we're going to talk about the dynamic weather system that it has, and oh my god, does it really affect the way you play the game. I mean, I'm going in like, 20 minutes, and then there's a sandstorm of all sorts, and I'm in a tank, and I can't see nothing, literally. It just really heightens the level of playing field, you know, from the snipers that have to move and switch to a new class to all sorts of other stuff, and I really love it. I enjoy it. It's just a welcome feature. It's like evolution for Battlefield 1, brought from Battlefield 4, so good one on that, DICE. Another thing I'd like to talk about is the game's UI. Man, is that thing clean. Obviously, they took some things from Star Wars Battlefront and they put it in Battlefield 1, and it looks really neat, organized, all neat and tidy, and I'm really glad that they brought that into Battlefield 1. And the third thing is also something that they took from Battlefront, the graphics. That thing, it really stuns. I mean, I had to wait for the graphics drivers for my GTX to come in, and it really did help it. I got from 75 to 89 frames, and it doesn't dip down below that. So also, it is really optimized, and that's a definite plus. And another thing that I like are the classes. They're unique to themselves, and this year, it's no longer the way you're used to, where the assault class cannot do anything about the tanks. Where, you know, now if you're an assault, you just pretty much get a chance to take on the tanks. No more of that support stuff or the snipers getting the C4. That just doesn't how it work now. So I'm really glad, because I use assault all the time. But the only downside to it is that I feel like the anti-tanks grenades really don't work well. But I hope they fix that. Now on to the bad stuff. First off, let's obviously start about the servers. Keep in mind that this video is being posted a day after the server issues. Now, it got all fixed and stuff, but I was experiencing this and I was not really happy. The servers are a huge thing. I mean, there was no problem letting people in who was a Battlefield insider. But then as soon as the open beta was released, you know, problems left and right, couldn't connect, matchmaking failed, servers couldn't connect. This is the exact type of problem we were talking about from the original Battlefields, where you couldn't connect, server issues, day one. I really hope that this is not one of them. People spend $60 for this type of games, and they can't even play it. The second thing I want to talk about are the shutters. I don't know if this is a problem that you experience, but for me, I run into a building, and I get really good kill streaks, and then I have to deal with the fact that I can't really vault through a shutter. It just sucks. And the last thing I'd like to add is the OP little tanks. Fix them. They suck. I can't stand getting destroyed by a little tank when I have a heavy tank. Do that and I'm a happy camper for Battlefield 1. Alright, thank you guys. It's the end of the video. And if you enjoyed what you watched, please hit the subscribe button so I can make more content for you guys. I'll be doing this for you nonstop. And if I decided for my video schedules, I'm going to be doing Monday, Wednesdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. One video at 4 o'clock. That's how I'm going to be running the show right now. So yeah, thank you. Oh, and I have a 5% discount code from CinchGaming. It's pretty much like a scuff controller type thing, but it's really awesome. 5% off down in the description below. And the beat that I use for my background music, it's really sick. Also, download link in the description down below and the YouTube channel. Thank you guys and peace out.
Orada bir gözcü var. Onlarınkilerden biri.
The enemy has armed objective apples. Objective apples.
İçlerden biri.
Enemy coordinates have been sent to our artillery.
Objective apples.